The LUMIX S1H launch event in Hollywood was the first opportunity to get my hands on the new camera, along with a bunch of other media, and be sure to play Spot the YouTuber throughout this video. We started in the Dolby screening room at the Hollywood Vine Theater, housing the single best theater projection in Hollywood, which, as one guest pointed out, really tells you just how much confidence Panasonic has in the S1H footage. We watched the launch and a technical presentation on the S1H, which was live streamed, by the way, link below, then went to the Goya Studios soundstage to get hands-on time with the cameras. Panasonic had built a series of sets to shoot with fully kitted out S1H cameras with Atlas Orion anamorphic lenses and Atomos recorders, which, by the way, will record raw video from the S1H in the near future. The rigs were pretty impressive, and since I know a lot of us are interested in the new tilting free angle monitor, here's how that works. We watched a series of short films shot on the S1H and had a Q&A session with each of the filmmakers. These shorts are all available on YouTube now. You're watching a piece of the sizzle reel here, but in the description below, I've linked to a playlist of all of these shorts. They're all worth watching.
As you can see, we have some sets here and we're ready to hand out cameras.
The first thing I did with the camera was go through the menus. Some highlights: audio gain has a new low setting and levels now go down to minus 18. And quite possibly my favorite new feature, there's finally a red frame one recording option so you know when you've hit record. There's also tally lights on the back and front of the camera. Pretty cool. I ran through the recording options and captured all 7 pages of settings because I know some of you will be really interested in this. Just pause on any screen you want to get a closer look at, or scrub forward about 30 more seconds to skip all of these. The first shots I recorded were using the cameras that Panasonic had set up, with 2x anamorphic lenses shooting in V-Log. These were shot 48p, so I've slowed them down to play frame for frame on this 30p timeline. In addition to VFR, the cameras can now record natively in 1080p at 120 frames per second in 10-bit, which means you get audio and autofocus for slow motion. Now, watch this. Notice how I blew the highlights in this shot. But since it's 10-bit, that can be recovered. This is shot in 6K, first playing back scaled down to 65% to fill the 4K frame, then again at 100%, punching into the shot but still viewing 1-to-1 pixels. This is what I'm most excited about, the ability to reframe and still deliver 4K without scaling up. That covers everything that I had video for, but of course there's a lot more bullet points that I want to go through, so let's just start with some of the specs. As you probably know, it is a 24.2 megapixel full frame sensor, but what you may not have realized is that this sensor actually has a low pass filter on it. Now, why is the low pass filter back? The GX8 was the first LUMIX camera to remove the low pass filter, and the GH5, GH5S, G9, S1, and S1R are all lacking the low pass filter as well. By taking that off, you increase sharpness. The image becomes a little bit sharper. By putting it back on, the image does get a little bit softer, but what you gain is the elimination of moiré, which can obviously be a problem in video. It also has the side benefit of actually making the image look a little bit more filmic. As you can imagine, film is not perfectly sharp, so having the low-pass filter back on there just adds to the S1H's film look. The full sensor, full area of the sensor, of course, records at 6K and 24p, and the great benefit of that is something called open gate. Back in the days of film, you shot full-frame 35mm film and then had a lot of room to reframe or crop in post, and you have that again when you're shooting open gate and full 3:2 aspect ratio. If you don't need full 3.2, if you want to go to 16:9, you get to shoot at 5.9K, so just barely a little bit less, and you can do that all the way up to 30p. If you want to shoot in cinema 4K, you can go up to 60p in 10-bit. The camera also features dual native ISO, and that's 100 and 640 when you're shooting in a non-log mode, and it's 640 and 4000 native in log. The camera also features dual SD card slots, so we're back to what we had on the GH5 and the G9, not the SD and the QXD slot. XQD. It doesn't have XQD like the S1 and S1R do. It just doesn't need that much bandwidth to deliver the video that the S1H does. The camera has 14 plus stops of dynamic range, including VLOG and VGamut. And the VGamut gives you access to the Vericam LUT library of 35 different looks that are very popular among the Vericam world. The camera also supports, and I'm probably going to explain this somewhat incorrectly, but it supports IDT, or Input Device Transform, which, as I understand it, allows you to make the look of the camera conform to the ACES, that's the Academy Color System, which means that it can perfectly match cameras from any other manufacturer. Basically, any cinema camera can be made to match using this format or this system. Again, I'm explaining it incorrectly, I'm sure, but the point is you can make this color match any other cinema camera. The camera offers support for a variety of anamorphic D-squeezes and matches the 4 perf size to make the most of classic anamorphic lenses. It, of course, has 5-axis in-body stabilization, which I think came as a surprise to a lot of people. We expected to see possibly the removal of in-body stabilization like we lost in the GH5S when going with the dual native ISO, but here in the S1H, we have the best of both. And that is giving us 6.5 stops of image stabilization. Now, Panasonic said that is near gimbal-like stability for handheld work. I don't know if I'd go that far. You're not going to walk down the street and expect to get gimbal smoothness, but if you're standing and holding it, you're going to get some pretty solid shots. You also get unlimited recording time, like you get with the GH5 and GH5S. There are hot swappable SD card slots, so as one fills up and it switches over to the other, you can simply swap out the full card. But you also get simultaneous recording internal and out over the HDMI, which offers some interesting workflow possibilities where you could record one format internally and another externally for a proxy workflow, for example. Now, because of that HDMI out and cooperation with Atomos, we do know that we are going to be getting raw recording over HDMI out in the near future. The camera is freeze resistant down to minus 10 degrees Celsius and dust and splash proof, even with the vent. And I think this is an interesting thing to think about. There is an air vent on this camera. It is actually air cooled. And you might think, well, hold on, how can air go through the camera but not water and dust? Well, you have to remember, and this is a story that Matt told at the presentation, that Panasonic is used to building air cooled, water resistant hardware. They've been building Panasonic Toughbooks, which are notebooks that are military grade for a very long time. And those machines are really strong and really tough and water resistant. Matt actually told a story of spilling, I think, apple juice onto the keyboard of a Toughbook and cleaning it out by holding it under the kitchen faucet. The way that it works is the air vent actually doesn't pass air through the camera itself. It's passing it over basically a heat sink. So the camera itself is weather sealed. The entire LCD display enclosure is weather sealed. And then the air is passed between those two enclosures. Last little note, you get time code in and out via the PC port, which means you can not only sync it up with other cameras, but you can jam sync the S1H as well. And the price, as you probably have heard, $39.99, available for pre-order now. Use the link below, please. And it'll be shipping at the end of September. So that's it. That is the S1H. What do you guys think? It's a heck of a camera. It's big. It's awesome. It does 6K. It's full frame. It's kind of everything that you want in a camera. I'd love to hear your thoughts about it. Tell me what you think below. And of course, if you haven't subscribed to the channel yet, make sure you do that. We'll be talking about the S1H a whole bunch more as time goes on.